Hi, welcome back to The Shtick. This week we're on a trip. We're actually looking at medicinal cannabis, and one of the people who's of great interest or is very interested in the whole scenario is in my studio right now, and his name is Ian Abramowitz.
Abramowitz.
Wits. Well, you've got to have your wits about you these days.
Yeah. Especially in the cannabis business.
So you don't say vich, it's wits.
Wits, yeah.
So is that Lithuanian wits?
Lithuanian, all the way from Jaga via South Africa.
Jaga. Fantastic. And you were in Cape Town or Johannesburg? I knew it was one or the other.
Well, yes. Cape Town is the most beautiful city. Johannesburg had the biggest Jewish population.
Right, and then you ended up in Toronto.
I landed up in Toronto. I was kind of come to Australia, but my younger brother persuaded me to choose Canada instead.
Well, we've got enough South Africans here.
I believe so.
Yeah, we've got heaps.
But I believe it's a better place for their involvement.
I don't know.
Not that it was a bad place to start with, but we've added
judging.
Value.
So we want to know, what's your shtick, Ian?
My shtick? I don't know. You tell me what you want to talk about.
Well, we're talking about CannTrust.
Yes. So CannTrust is a publicly traded company. It trades on the Toronto Stock Exchange. It was started 5 years ago. I was not there at that time. 7 employees. I was employee number 77. They hired me as the chief financial officer when they decided that they wanted to go public. And our payroll last Friday was 570. So that's where we are today.
Wow, 570 million or people?
570 people.
Oh, right.
570 people. So a lot of growth.
That is big.
That is huge.
And that's just in Canada?
That's just in Toronto, yeah. Right. So we have two facilities. We have a post-production manufacturing facility in a place called Vaughan, a city just north of Toronto.
Mm-hmm.
We have about 300 plus my people there, and then we have a greenhouse just near Niagara Falls, which is an hour and a half away from that, and that's where we grow the stuff, and then we process it at the head office.
And now you're exporting it?
We are exporting it. And we're very proud to be associated with Tommy and with Cannatrek. We see in this company, we see a mirror image of where we were.
Mm-hmm.
5 years ago, and we see Australia as a country that is maybe 5 years behind where we were, and we hope to replicate the success that we've enjoyed there here.
So you've invested in Cannatrek and
want to
see it grow.
Want to see it grow, yes.
And that's what it's all about. You've come to Australia to...
My first trip to Australia.
And you've come to
my role is changing. I'm currently the CFO.
Mm-hmm.
We've received approval to list on the New York Stock Exchange in addition to the TSX. I don't possess the capital markets experience to play that role, so we've found a replacement for myself. And because our strategy is now global, my new role will be Senior Vice President of Global Investments and Partnerships. And he's our second investment.
Well,
they are. So it's.
And you're heading to Denmark for another.
I got you on Sunday. I fly home on Sunday. I'm at home for 2 days, and then Tuesday night I fly to Denmark to attend a board meeting in Copenhagen on Wednesday.
Fantastic.
Yes.
And what do you think about the Australian potential here?
I think it'll be a mirror image, plus or minus, whatever that means, of whatever it is everywhere else in the world. Now, I said, I may be suitable for the role that I serve, but it's not through any personal experience in cannabis. I'm 64 years old. I've never, ever smoked a joint in my life, so I have no personal point of reference. But we have more than 60,000 patients, one of whom is my 89-year-old mother-in-law, and so we've changed dramatically for them. We've given more than 60,000 people quality of life that they didn't possess before they started using cannabis for medical reasons.
And this is exactly what I want to hear and exactly what everybody wants to know. And this is the progress that we're looking for in changing the mindset and the idea of what cannabis is all about. And there's another aspect as well, which is hemp.
Yes.
Hemp as a product.
As a source of CBD. So you know the difference between THC and CBD, and So there are two types of cannabis, primarily. One makes you high, the other one doesn't. The association of anybody that doesn't know that, you know, you smoke cannabis, it can get high. But interestingly, 60% of what of our business is not smokables, it's extracts. Mm-hmm. That's the highest percentage of extracts in any of the companies that we compete against in Canada. 60% of the extracts are CBD, is CBD, mm-hmm. and 60% plus or minus of the people that use that product are females.
Really?
So, and the top four conditions that we treat or that people come to us to use it or get prescribed for is anxiety, depression, insomnia, and pain.
And what about epilepsy?
Yeah, absolutely. All those, yeah.
That's the very important
one. My wife is a speech pathologist. She treats pediatric patients. Mm. Many of them have seizure disorders, and so she tells me anecdotally, child can be in therapy with her, starts acting up, mother puts a few drops under the tongue, and within 30 seconds there's a calmness that comes over that person. So it's a wonderful thing, you know, and our anecdotal evidence also is that the majority of the people that are supposedly recreational users are actually self-medicating. So we think there's an opportunity to make the world to improve the quality of people's lives here as we are doing in North America.
And the laws in Canada, Justin Trudeau is a pretty cool prime minister. Do you think he's okay?
Yeah, I mean, listen, he's certainly the poster child.
I think he smoked one or two joints.
More than one or two, yes. time will tell. You know, yeah. I mean, certainly he puts a good face, I'm proud to be associated with Canada, whether it was Harper before or Trudeau now. But yes, certainly he got this thing over the finish line, and for that we should be grateful, because I think it's a good thing.
And there's for recreational purposes, is there?
It became law on the 17th of October. So we were the 15th licensed producer to be granted a license by Health Canada. Mm-hmm. Today there are about 140 plus or minus licensed producers in Canada, with another 400 plus or minus in the pipeline.
Wow, so it's going to be
but
massive.
It was medicinal up until, and there were approximately 350,000 licensed users, medical users, of which we service, not all the time, but we have more than 60,000 registered patients. So it's a big population, but it became, you could buy it recreationally as of October the 17th, so you can either go through your doctor or you can go to the store, if you wish.
Ian, it's been a real pleasure to meet you today. You just flew into town,
yes,
to Melbourne. Welcome to Melbourne. And we'll be ending the show now, because we've had a really interesting group of people.
I got to wear a hat and a waistcoat, and so this is an unusual experience I had no idea I would be experiencing when I woke up this morning.
That's it.
And I didn't have to take cannabis to do it.
No, yeah. I know, you're a very straight guy. We'll be back next week with more Shtick, and I'd like to say thank you again.
Well, thank you for having me.
Okay, shalom.
Shalom. Shalom.